Hello.
Hey.
Robert. I'm Robert.
And I'm Jason.
Wow.
And we got Matt Books with us again today.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's Matt.
It's me.
Again, our first returning guest.
That's right, because I'm the best.
The only person who hasn't ran away from us and never looked back.
I'm the fan favorite, baby. Yeah.
Yeah.
We were supposed to have some other guy on, but he wasn't here.
Who was that?
We had to...
Oh, yeah.
We had to go with Matt instead.
Man, he's always bothering me. Like, why can't I be on the show? Like, we should be on when we do this. Stupid.
Hey, what can I say?
But Matt, he's here.
I think we had a poll recently on the forum, and they were saying who's the favorite guest. I think you won.
Really?
Yeah, I think you might have. I don't remember, but I think you may have.
I think you beat Sammy. I'm not sure.
Actually, it's gone now because the forums were deleted.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
But, yeah, you were the favorite.
Sweet. I'll try not to let you fans down.
Yeah. So, what's up, Matt?
Let me check. Nothing.
Oh, good.
Really?
Absolutely nothing, yeah.
Absolutely nothing.
Just in a state of constant readiness for the incoming hurricane.
Not working on any movies or anything like that.
Well, I'm supposed to be taking pictures and stuff, but yeah, I haven't.
Oh, man. I wish my job was that easy. I wish I could just sit around and take pictures.
Because I've been sick and stuff.
I know.
Yeah, Matt has the plague.
Yeah, and I have insomnia too, which really
are you gonna
really
die?
Sucks. No, I don't think so.
Well, Matt's probably
maybe
about to die.
If I do, you can eat me.
Oh, eat you, then I get the plague, and then I die.
You're a fast one, damn.
Ooh, I'm a fast one. I'm fast and slippery, and full of goo and slime and yellow stuff.
What?
Kind of like my chest.
What? Ew. Yeah, see, I'm not eating that.
You never know. Might be good.
You know, I will see.
Oh, man.
Okay, yeah, this is scary.
Might be one of those things that just looks horrible, just awful. But it tastes great.
Talking about eating Matt's gooey body.
Like or it could taste like awful like and be like really, really good for you. Because that's
like
how things seem to work.
Yeah, really. Or maybe it tastes really, really good and then I die of a plague.
Yeah, that could work too. It's
who
like
knows?
Elephant ears. Tastes really, really good, but then it kills you.
So this is KnoxKast episode 13.
The Return of Matt.
This is 13, right?
This is bad luck. One of us might die. Well, I guess it's Matt.
I nominate myself.
And then me, if I'm feeling really adventurous.
Knox will die from a horrible fence-climbing accident.
Probably.
Oh, yeah.
Jason's gonna get killed by a hurricane again.
Yeah, freaking hurricanes.
Knox will be filming On the Fence 2, and he'll be saying, I'm on the fence, and then he'll slip and impale himself.
Oh,
and then it'll sound more like,
stupid...
I'm on the fence! I'm on the fence!
Can you show my video blog?
Yeah, I sent him a link.
Oh, God.
Somebody help me! I'm on the fence!
Yes, that's exactly what I would say. Help me, I'm on a fence.
I'm bleeding on the fence!
I am not going to be killed by a fence. Oh, God.
So let's open some fan mail.
Tasty fan mail.
Yeah, from Ryan. Do you have any tips for a beginner in filmmaking?
Yeah. You won't go blind from doing it.
What about you, Jason?
Don't do it. Don't get into this profession.
Don't expect to make money.
You'll make no money. You'll work all the time. You'll have no time to do anything else. And eventually you'll go insane.
And if you do, don't animate. Don't do clay animation.
Yeah.
Or she'll, you'll end up like me.
Yeah, in all honesty, this is a very rewarding field, except, it's not rewarding yet.
It's a little rewarding for me, but,
it's rewarding for you. But,
yeah, but I'm probably gonna be broke in about 5 years.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's all gonna be gone.
Alright, let's find some other email here.
Now that I'm really depressed, let's go on to the next one.
In science news, did you guys know that, the next couple of days, the planet Mars is supposed to be closer to the Earth than it's ever been?
Really?
Yeah.
What the hell? Goddamn aliens.
It's supposed to be, like, gigantic. Like, you should be able to see it with the naked eye.
The naked eye.
Yeah.
Ooh.
That'll be pretty cool. I have to look out for that when my roof gets blown off.
Yeah, when you can try and peer through the 30,000 feet of clouds and rain.
Yeah. Freaking Ernesto coming right towards my house.
Ernesto.
Hola, yeah,
Ernesto.
For anyone who wants to see the great luck I've had with hurricanes, go to spatulamadness.com/blog. My production blog there.
You know what you should do?
What's that?
You should put up the video from Orlando.
I actually linked it in the...
Oh, you did?
Yeah, the documentary thing I did on Charlie.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's linked. Yeah, that's...
Yeah, I saw that video the other day for the first time.
Yeah.
A couple of weeks ago. It was crazy.
That's what hurricanes are like.
It's got the world-famous Gian in it.
Yeah.
I would know, because nothing interesting has ever happened in Texas.
Waco?
What?
That was pretty interesting.
What?
Yeah, Waco.
Waco?
Yeah, you know that town where David Koresh had all his followers and they pretty much burned themselves to death rather than get arrested?
That was pretty awesome.
I think the one thing, and I've never heard about it. Maybe I'm just an idiot. Maybe
never heard
about Alamo. The Alamo. And there's another similar...
There's the Alamo.
There's another similar instance in history.
Damn Mexicans. Goddamn Mexicans. They're everywhere.
The Alamo.
The Alamo.
Does anyone here remember the Alamo?
I think we're all supposed to remember the Alamo.
I remember the Alamo.
You know, I don't. I'd forgotten.
Well then...
If I remembered it, I'd be pretty old. Yeah.
You don't... Okay, so what's the next fan mail?
Let's see.
We only answered, like, one so far, right?
From Rick. That thingy...
Hi, Rick.
Hi. Hi, Rick. How are you doing, Rick? I hope Rick's listening. I like Rick.
Rick, we want you to know that we care about you as a person.
We care about you as a person...
But we don't ever want to meet you.
Rick, how come you never talk to me? Rick, how come you never talk to me anymore?
If we ever saw you in the street, Rick, we would probably call the cops.
I wouldn't call the cops, because I'd be running him over. I don't want the cops there. Back him over with a Chevy.
That's because you don't care about him as a person.
Well, no, I care about him as a person. It's just, you know, I care about him more as a flattened, dead person.
For his personal safety. And my own, by keeping him 50 feet away from me at all times.
Yeah.
Oh, but go on with this question.
Okay, let's see. That thingy that shows up to the left of the address bar when you go to your site bears an amazing resemblance to that of Walmart. Were you aware of this, or was it meant to be satirical towards Walmart?
Obviously, Rick has found out the secret conspiracy that Steele has in place.
I think he's talking about Robert's site.
He's really... Oh. Knox is really a part of Walmart's conglomerate.
I don't know. He's saying something about your site and something about the nav bar being satirical of Walmart.
They're both puppets of Walmart. All right, next question.
The navigation?
No, really. I want to figure out what this question even means. The thing that shows up to the left of the address bar when you go to your site bears an amazing resemblance to that of Walmart.
I don't know. I just wanted to make a Knox site. That's all I had in mind. I just wanted to make
I have no idea what's going on in that question.
If you go to the automotive section of any Walmart, and you see the secret phrase. They will open up a doorway that will lead you into the Knox only part of the store. Thousands of dollars in Knox merchandise, plush toys, posters, memorabilia, and coming soon, the new Knox DVD.
Of course, you're going to need a gold ticket before that, before I show you the magical Knox store.
That's right. It's only for a select few.
The only way to get the gold ticket is at night when Knox is sleeping to sneak into his room and cuddle
blow
up next
gently
to
on his face.
Cuddle up next to me.
Knox, I'm your biggest fan!
Jason has six gold tickets already from that.
Yeah,
he
I'm just swimming in gold tickets, let me tell you.
I'm starting to wonder why he hasn't used any of those. I think he just...
It's because he's broke, too.
Let's see. From Smart Toon Kid, Jason, can you post a picture of yourself on your blog? Because I'm 10 and not allowed to go on MySpace.
Ew?
How's he allowed to listen to this show?
I don't know. Why do you want a picture of me? That's...
creepy. You should do like a Tiger Beat pose type poster and post that on your site.
Yeah. Well, I've got a... Actually, if you want to see me, buy the new Knox Clay World series DVD. There's a video of me dressed as a bandito making a grilled cheese sandwich.
Oh, wow.
Jason
or go to FilmCow.com.
Yeah, and watch some of my movies.
Yeah.
I'm in a couple of them, except...
But, you know, all that may be too complicated, so you may end up having to just post a picture of yourself.
Yeah.
Jason is one hot tamale.
Okay, from...
spicy one.
From some... I don't know who this is from, because they've got a name in the address bar, and they've also signed it totally differently, and I can't pronounce how they signed it. It's like S-Ride-y some... I don't know. Dear Iron Man and Knox on Doors.
The hell?
I don't know. If you are free falling in the sky, above a barren flatland, no parachute, no people around, no way of survival, what would you do?
Fall.
What would you think of last? What would you do last?
I'd swear a lot.
I think I've already mentioned what I'd be thinking of when Gian was on.
Oh, yeah, you did.
When thinking of me falling thousands of feet to my death, just picture Yosemite Sam and insert horrible curse words instead.
Oh, yeah.
Do you realize that, like, kids these days probably don't even know who Yosemite Sam is?
That's crazy.
I don't know, I mean, what other answer could we get for that except we'd be really, really...
I would be thinking about turnips.
Well, yeah.
I mean, honestly, some random thought would probably, go into my head, and I just think about turnips all the way down.
That's actually a good idea. Die with no worries, just turnips.
Yeah, just turnips.
And I probably wouldn't give up. I try all kinds of things. I try to use my shirt as a parachute.
Yeah.
Of course, that probably wouldn't work. I'd die, but, you know, it's good to try.
He'd be flapping his arms like a bird.
Like, I'm not gonna die.
Okay, from Henry, what is your number one favorite movie of all time?
We did this one already.
Did we?
Yeah, last time I was on, in fact.
Well, hey.
Oh my god, we're like some kind of time warp.
Okay. Alright. Let's see. From Zach, I would like to know what both of you would do if could use a time machine.
Obviously, Zach is a Neanderthal.
Have we gotten this question, too?
What's that?
We've gotten this question, too.
We might have. I don't know.
We may, too. Okay. What I would do is I would go into the future. And,
And what? All right, Knox.
Time is not a thing to be screwed with.
There you go. But
that's what I would do. I'd go into the future and I'd be like, you know what? I shouldn't be doing this.
What about you, Matt?
If I could travel back in time?
Yeah.
I'd rather go into the future. Do I have to go back?
What do you want to do in the future, man?
I'd want to go to the future because if you go into the past, you'll screw things up. But
yeah, you know.
But then if you go into the future,
there's tons of cool stuff in the future.
You know, you can't screw anything up in the future until it becomes your past.
And then, but the thing is, if you go to the future and then come back, everything here would suck in comparison to the future.
I know,
but then
it depends on if the future is like really screwed up.
True.
Yeah, there's
this Woody Allen movie called Sleeper. That's a pretty messed up future. There's like giant bananas and
Planet of the Apes messed up.
Yeah, that's really giant messed up. Yeah, giant bananas, yeah. Man.
Yeah.
That was the great. That's an awesome movie. The Woody Allen film Sleeper.
I don't watch anything Woody Allen makes.
Woody Allen's the best. It is probably one of the greatest.
He married his adopted daughter.
She was she wasn't his adopted daughter.
You gotta separate the artist from the person.
She wasn't actually his adopted daughter because he never married what's her name.
But they adopted her.
No, she was adopted before Woody Allen even knew her.
It's still weird.
Yeah.
They're not through blood, okay?
If I ever met the guy, I'd be like, hey, little guy, you're weird. This is for every American out there. We think you're weird.
Anyway, so Woody Allen in this movie Sleeper was going, and he was trying to steal this giant banana so he could eat. And so he starts like peeling the banana to try to steal it, and this guard sees him and runs after him, and they spend about 5 minutes slipping over the banana peel over and over again. And I thought that was a great side gag there, you know, a 5 minute banana slip scene.
You need to send me that movie too. You sent me Bananas, which has no bananas in it. I gotta see this. I gotta see this movie because it actually has bananas.
Yeah, it actually has a banana. Yeah, I'll send you this. I'll send you Love and Death and a bunch of other Woody Allen movies.
I like bananas.
Yep.
So send me more of that stuff.
More. You guys are weird.
Okay, from Dustin. Of course, you both make movies, but you also have your limitations in terms of visual effects and budget. My question is, if those limits were lifted and you could make any kind of movie you wanted, what would it be? I would make a 3-hour epic that's just hippopotamuses flying around New York City and slamming into things.
Wow.
You know, that is actually a great idea.
I'm glad you think so, Knox.
Put Brad Pitt in it and Will Smith.
They'll all be hippopotamuses.
See, Will Smith would be the funny black guy, and Brad Pitt would be the stuck-up white guy. You get it?
Yeah.
Genius.
There you go. What about you, Matt? What kind of movie would you make?
I would make either a CG or a live-action movie based on a character that I'm not allowed to talk about.
Fun.
All right.
Have fun guessing what that character is, kids.
I'd make villain.
Yeah, that movie's gonna be impossible to make.
Yeah.
Just get Weta. Give up already.
Oh, God, I can't give up.
No, I mean, hire Weta and stop, you know, doing it yourself.
No, I'll do anything to not have to animate ever again.
Spend the millions of dollars necessary to hire Weta and just do it.
I need slaves.
Okay, we gotta.
Either that or I'd make a sock puppet movie.
Sock puppet
trilogy. A trilogy. It'd be like Lord of the Rings. It'd be three of them. It'd be three.
Steele has found this out firsthand.
Sock puppet movies.
Yeah. Got an email from Adil.
Hello, Adil.
I think it's Adil. They actually said if it's too hard to pronounce, just say it's spelled Adil.
Dil.
Adil. I don't know.
Adil what?
Adil.
I don't know. They gave a pronunciation key, but I still don't know how to pronounce it.
Is it Adil pickle? Adil sausage? What is it?
I don't know. How much money do you make for the radio show?
Oh, boy. I can tell you how much I make, Adil.
I'll tell you exactly.
$1 million.
I think it's actually... It probably cost Robert money to do this because of the server costs. Yeah, we make absolutely no money.
Yeah, it actually does. If anything, I'm losing money because of this.
This show doesn't make any money. It loses money.
And Jason, you know, he doesn't lose any money or getting money.
No.
In fact, he's the one who's getting the money because he's getting more fans because of the show.
Exactly.
You know, I mean, I see all these people adding you on MySpace.
I know, I've got...
Like, Jesus Christ.
All these people.
You know, and now they're Jason fans. And some of them don't even like me anymore.
Like, one of these days, I'll get fans, and then I'll steal them from Jason, and then you can steal them back from me, and it'll be a full circle.
Yeah, I'm actually I'm planning on that. If I don't blow my brains out already, I'm probably gonna kill myself soon. Blow my
cool.
brains out.
Cool. Take pictures so we can, you know, get like, you know, on CNN or something.
I can't take pictures if I'm dead.
Okay, all right, stream it.
There you go.
The most depressing conversation.
Live. Robert Benfer kills himself.
At an undisclosed location.
Okay, I'm ready.
Hold on, I'm gonna put a gun in my mouth. There we go. Goodbye.
I'm gonna shoot while I jump off the cliff. I'm gonna jump off and shoot at the same time. That's gonna be cool.
Everybody see me?
Here, it's kind of rope around my neck. I'm gonna hang myself and shoot myself. My head's gonna fly off.
This is the part where it's 3D.
Oh man. I got an email from Potter Harry.
How original.
Harry? Yeah.
I don't know how they got that name.
At least it's not Dahmer Jeffrey.
What question would you ask the president and or God?
And or God?
That's quite a comparison there.
Yeah.
The president does not equal God, kids.
I do.
And I command you to give me money.
I'm God.
All of it. Even your parents.
Yeah. So what would you ask God, Robert?
I'd be like, why? You know, what the hell's going on? Seriously.
I would ask something similar.
Like,
really?
You know, just...
I would say, like, why Spring Hill, man? Of all the places to drop me?
Why Texas?
You know what I'd ask?
God, what are you gonna
ask? What would you ask?
I'll tell you exactly what I'm gonna ask.
I was hoping you would.
I'm gonna ask, you know, what's up with wisdom teeth, man? Wisdom teeth suck. That was a bad idea. That
maybe
really hurt
when I had to
take them out.
That's not perfect either, okay? Okay,
seriously.
I guess God is.
Maybe we just have to grow into our wisdom teeth.
What about the president, Jason?
Ow.
What happened?
Just had a really, like, high-pitched...
He's dying.
I heard that, too, you know, I was... What would I ask the president?
Yeah.
Man, I have no idea.
I know what I'd ask.
What?
Can I push the button?
There you go.
Come on, let me push it. I want to push it. I want to push the button. Where's it at? Is it right there? Can I push it?
Man, I would push the button. Man, I would be the worst president ever.
I would be the best president.
How do you know that you'd be the best president, Jason?
I would totally, like, rename all the states.
The president can't do that, can they?
No.
Doesn't matter. If I say I'm renaming all the states, you know, people will listen to it. Even if it's not official, people will.
Yeah,
the guy who
and
made
then
the
on
hippo movie.
The evening news. This just in: President Steele has gone insane.
You know, I name. You know, I take the.
Members of Congress have asked the United States citizens to kill him if they see him.
I take the cool states like New York. You know. And I named them cool names like Manatee Central.
What about Texas, mate?
In Texas, yeah, like right. I named Texas. Let's see, Cactus Land.
Oh, God.
Cactus Land.
Florida. What about Florida?
It's funny before now.
Florida.
Just cutting me in the heart. And
I named Florida. Stay away.
Down.
I figured that would be like Louisiana.
Well, that too. Stay Away 2, the sequel to Stay Away.
Or, you know what would be a good one for Louisiana? Corpse Land.
Oh, man, that would be in bad taste, Matt.
Corpse Land, think of it. Think of how it rolls off the tongue. Kids in elementary school would definitely remember Corpse Land.
Man, I was...
I think Knox is having a seizure.
Yeah.
What did I say, Jason? I said if you made one more Texas joke, I would leave, bro. Leave.
It's always the same Texas joke. I was talking about either Spurs or cactuses.
Yeehaw, Texas.
It still cuts me in the heart.
He's a true Texan.
Yeah.
I wish I was dead, don't you, Jason?
He's not a happy person.
The show is going places, let me tell you.
Isn't it? Wow. So entertaining. So glad you guys brought me on for your unprepared show.
Yeah.
You're going to be like, wow, that Matt guy, he really knows how to screw things up. Don't ever bring him on again.
Let's try.
I can see the forum messages now. Hey, Jason, was that last show made? What was that last show made of? It seemed to me like it was made of fail and AIDS.
Yeah, pretty much. Man, I think... The show, you know, it started off okay, and then it just never left okay land.
Now it's
just stayed in okay village.
We're hovering on the edge of mediocrity.
Yeah, the edge.
What's the next fan mail?
We're right in the center of mediocrity. What are you talking about?
Oh no, we're about to fall off into suckiness.
Here we go. I gotta. I'm not gonna read any more fan mail. Instead, I'm gonna read this junk mail I got in the mail today. From Singular, raising the bar. Two free phones. See inside, special offer.
See, this is the point where people get confused and they think you're actually doing a plug for a company, when in fact, you're really not.
No.
You're just reading your junk mail.
Yeah, let's see. Let's look at this. Oh, look at this. Dear Jason Steele, you've got two free Nokia 6030 color screen phones coming to you when you activate it. New lines of service, and qualified calling plans.
Dude, send me one.
You're already pre-approved for wireless service.
Awesome.
To get your two free phones, just call and say, send them now.
Two free phones?
All I have to do is call and say, send them now.
Wow.
I mentioned these phones are free, and they are. You'll get two Nokia 6030 phones that retail for $119.99 each, but if you call now, they are free after rebate and two-year agreement.
So, have any of you guys seen any interesting movies lately?
There's more good
junk
news.
Mail thing isn't going anywhere.
You'll get great coverage from Singular.
I'd rather get a
film
with no Novocaine than hear him read his junk mail.
Actually, I've seen about 10 Woody Allen films lately.
Oh my God, go away, Woody Allen! I mean, in the movie theater.
Let's see. I watched Annie Hall. I watched Bananas.
In the movie theater.
Love and Death, Manhattan.
In the
play the game, Sam. Sleeper.
In the movie
Take
theater.
The Money and Run. What's up,
in the movie theater.
No, I haven't actually.
Thank you.
Banana, 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 banana.
Very good, Knox. You said banana.
Banana, banana, banana.
See, now, the show's starting to pick up now. We should just cut out the last 20 minutes and start from here.
Hi, banana, I'm Matt. You may remember me from such episodes as episode 10.
Ding dong, ding dong, ding ding ding.
And that's Knox.
You were in episode 10. You were in episode 8.
Oh, ha! That was a test for all you KnoxKast junkies out there. That'll be on the DVD. You watch out for that one, boy.
Oh, man, I forgot about that. I have this huge... this huge thing of pomegranate juice here that I have to put in the fridge.
Yuck.
Tax.
Let's see.
I have tax.
Knox is the head of the Children Who Ate Lead Paint Chip Society.
In 1961, R.W. Knudsen started bottling fruit juice from his grape vineyard in one condition.
You're reading off the pomegranate juice bottle.
Yes. He insisted his juices never contain artificial flavors or preservatives. I can see this guy standing in the middle of his grape vineyard. Hello! Anyone who's listening, I insist that none of my juices contain artificial flavors or preservatives.
Yeah. When did he start it?
1961.
Yeah, I'm so sure he was... Actually, yeah, he's probably a hippie. So it was probably more like, hey, man, I don't want any chemicals other than the ones I pick in there. Okay?
I think you're right. Listen to this. Little did R.W. Knudsen know, he was starting a tradition of innovation in health-conscious products.
Are you choking a fish?
booklet. Let me have a booklet today.
Number one single on our hand from Knox.
Yes.
Let me have a booklet today.
Why? This is what I'd ask God. I'd be like, why? Why this?
I got a box of vanilla wafers here.
Do you put peanut butter icing on them?
No, I don't.
It tastes good.
No, I have to try that. I actually give them to my dog.
That explains his peak physical fitness.
Hashbrown on a cell phone.
Well, you know, I got them for me, except they were stale, so I...
So you just kind of looked at him, and he was sitting there smelling funny, and you just kind of tossed him down there, didn't you?
Hashbrown got a wrong collar from sausage biscuit.
What?
Dental floss wears glasses.
There you go. Dental floss wears glasses. That's awesome. That's gonna be the title for this episode.
Hash brown on a cell phone, I think, was much better.
Dental floss wears glasses. I don't know. Dental floss wears glasses is the best.
Dental floss wears glasses. VHS tape smokes. Oh man.
You should be a beat poetry dude.
A beatnik. You gotta have like the little goatee thing going on just underneath your lip. Black turtleneck sweater, black beret.
Yeah, play some bongos.
People don't clap for you, they snap.
I wanna do that one day. I wanna do some sort of event where people snap for me instead of clapping.
Hey man, that was awesome. Snaps.
You get snaps with both hands from me.
Sometimes if I concentrate real hard, I can snap at the same time with both hands.
I got two fingers on my nose. Oh, I got two fingers on my nose. Oh, I got two fingers on my nose. Just sitting there hanging out.
Steele, I think it's time to push the emergency button and have everyone listen to you do the one-handed clap.
Fingers on my nose. I got two.
One-handed clap, yeah.
Let them hear it.
I don't know, Matt. I can clap with one hand. See, my hands are exceptionally big, and so the fingers actually extend to my wrist when I.
CD Burner is going grocery shopping. CD Burner is going grocery shopping. CD Burner is going grocery shopping.
Here we go, the one-handed clap. Ready? There it comes, one-handed clap.
Go for it.
CD Burner. More speakers.
Yeah.
CD Burner.
There you go.
It freaks me out just hearing it.
He's clapping with one hand right there.
He really was. The tips of his fingers touch his forearm when he does that. It's just, it hurts just looking at it.
The CD Burner needs a new CD player. The CD Burner needs.
I think this is how Knox goes to sleep at night. Like some people like think about relaxing things. Other people count sheep. Some people take Unisom, like I have. Or some.
Yeah, people don't realize this, but Knox is exactly like his movies in real life.
Robot.
Are you finished, Robert?
Are you done? Did you stop?
I think I'm about done. Yeah.
Well, welcome back to Earth, Robert.
Yes. We missed you.
I'm not ready, but...
We missed you.
I don't know how much of this saga you guys could handle.
Why is there screaming in the background?
You can hear that?
Yeah.
Oh, you're not supposed to hear that.
Are you murdering people, Knox?
I can't hear that at all. I guess it's because I got the music playing.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm torturing people in the background. I was singing to them.
That's his fan club. That's what happens when you hit the gold membership status of his fan club.
You get to enter the special gold membership room.
Get punked full of bleach and Windex.
The two chairs are having a conversation.
I must preserve you forever.
Oh, don't.
You're not blonde enough. You're not blonde enough.
I want fans forever. You go into his secret underground room. He has people hanging from the ceiling.
By their feet.
Yeah.
Oh, you have no idea.
They've been painted blue.
Yep. He acts out his movies with them in real life.
Yeah. That's how he rehearses.
I don't want to jump into the 2-foot shallow pool. Do it.
Do I hear typing?
No.
I bet Matt is playing WoW, isn't he?
No.
Are you playing WoW?
Oh, dare you type.
I bet you are. That's that's why the show is bad. It's because you're playing WoW.
No, it's not.
You're playing video games while we're supposed to be recording a radio show.
Shut up.
Well, we've reached a new low here on KnoxKast Radio.
Welcome to KnoxKast, where random screaming and weird noises are the norm.
Yeah, I think this is officially worse than college radio. Man, I was listening to this college radio station in Orlando, and this woman was saying this, like, 10-minute-long poem about dead cats.
I don't know, Jason, this is fun, but then again, I'm probably going to listen to this tomorrow and shoot myself.
No, I'm sure other people will shoot you before you get the chance.
They'll be like, hey, aren't you Knox? Yes, I am. Here he is, guys! Let's get him!
Oh, you're the guy who wouldn't shut up, mother. CD burners.
You're the one making all those weird noises, aren't you?
Like, hey, you were warned, okay? You've seen my movie. How long have we been doing this episode?
I don't know.
I don't know how long is this gonna go on. I'm just really tired right now. I think.
When does the hurting stop?
I'm just really tired.
A specter's memory. He moved on pussy willowed feet, a trail of velvet gray, like the hem of a lady's gown, skirting
brown. Oh my
god! A
gentle
breeze.
Censor this.
Of mew. And
he's
wiry
just getting horrible.
Tickles a shadow, eyes that danced with light,
well,
green and red.
Pepsi.
A conflagration of silent steps. I think it's a.
It sounded like Knox was just like walking through a pile of soda cans just then.
Yeah, I was reading poem for a dead cat. I searched for dead cat poetry on Google, and that's what came up.
Ew. Tell you what, I've been reading a lot on the internet about it, and really pumped, excited for the Transformers movie.
I'm not, it looks gay.
It's gonna be cool.
Looks gay.
Optimus Prime.
Looks gay. Everything I've seen about it looks gay.
Bumblebee.
You got all these freaking... Optimus Prime has, like, bright blue, like, cheesy fire decals and...
Optimus Prime. Starscream.
Haven't you seen the images that have come out?
I haven't seen any of, like, the actual robots. Did he just electrocute himself or something?
Oh, I have no idea. I thought that was you.
No.
You haven't seen the pictures that have come out?
Do they have any of, like, the actual robots?
Yeah.
No, they don't.
Yeah, they do. They look really bad.
Robots?
I just sent you a link to the...
Hey, come on, send me a link, Jason. Come on. I'll leave for 2 seconds and you're already hugging and kissing this guy over here.
What?
You see the link I sent you?
Yeah, I don't see any pictures, though.
Well, scroll down.
I think I just ate an ant.
It's good. It's got protein.
Damn it.
You see the pictures?
No, it's just lots of people commenting.
Well, there should be pictures that loaded.
Oh,
this is the most uninteresting episode we have ever had.
Oh, it looks cool, man. What are you talking about?
You see the Optimus Prime images?
Yeah.
You guys are just having your own little conversation. You're not even having a like an entertaining conversation, like talking to the audience. You're just talking about stuff that they don't.
I don't know. I think it looks kind of silly.
It's gonna be cool. You shut your mouth. You don't talk about Transformers. Right down there. Now stop you in your mouth.
It's a Michael Bay movie. Come on.
Okay, Jason, this is talking bad about Transformers.
It's Michael Bay.
We need to get past that.
You can't get past that because he's making the movie.
Bad Boys 2 was entertaining. This will be entertaining too.
Optimus Prime looks like he just got a paint job to go to a gay bar.
He looks cool.
What the hell are you guys talking about?
Look at these
about?
Cool flames I've got.
Oh, God.
These cool flame decals.
Dude, that is like...
This is going to be one of those episodes where you're going to eye me afterwards and you'd be like, yeah, that sucked. That sucked.
He pretty much I was told me before we even started that it's going to be horrible.
Yeah. Well, see, I don't know anything about Transformers, so I've never watched the show or the movie or anything, so... So I don't know what it's supposed to be like, but it's
gonna make a bajillion dollars just because
I remember Power Rangers.
I don't know. You see how bad Snakes on a Plane did?
Oh really? Did it do bad?
It did horribly.
I saw that movie. You sure? It did bad.
I saw that movie. It did really bad. Yeah.
It's how much did it cost to make?
Right now, I know what it was about.
It was released last week. Right now, it's number 6.
But how much did it cost to make?
$30 million.
How much has it made so far?
Let's see, Snakes in a Plane. It's number 7 right now at the box office. So far it's made...
I saw it.
I have not.
It was about snakes on
a plane.
It's
made $26 million.
It'll make more than it cost. And then we'll have, like, termites on a bus or something.
I don't know, because they were expecting it to do really good, but this is the second week of release, and it's number 7.
Why were they expecting it to do good?
We'll have, like, Japanese hornets on a bus, you'll see.
Why would... Like, I don't get it. Is this supposed to be, like... Was it made, like, as a joke, or is this, like, a really serious action movie?
It's meant to be, like,
totally
a...
serious, but...
Because I don't know if it's, like, a serious... action movie. I don't know if it's a really bad action movie or a really good comedy.
It's meant to be like an old 70s style grindhouse movie that, you know, you would only see in a drive-in.
Yeah, pretty much.
It has Keenan in it, from Keenan and Kel.
Yeah. He's
definitely for Keenan and Kel!
That's a good reason to
say that. Oh, here it goes!
I never watched Keenan or Kel, so I have no idea what he's talking about.
It's because they're black.
That's not why I never watched them.
Yeah. Who loves orange soda, Jason?
You know, I actually do like orange soda.
Oh, I hate that crap.
I prefer grape.
Kale loves orange soda. Hey, Arnold!
What?
Hey, Arnold.
Yeah.
Football head.
Worst show ever. I think all we're missing now is, like, we might as well just start drawing and ask the audience to, you know, guess what we're drawing.
Well, this isn't the worst episode. No, the worst episode ever was the original episode 11, which we actually recorded but then deleted.
Do you still have that?
Yeah,
on your
I still have it. We actually recorded the whole episode that was so bad. We decided to just totally record a new one, like, hours before it was supposed to air, just because it was so horrible.
Yeah. Wow. So it was an episode that's never been heard, and we'll probably
that wasn't, like, a
have,
guest
like,
episode, was it?
No.
Nothing else to release.
I think it was kind of like this episode, except without you.
Oh.
So,
does this episode suck, Jason? Should we just stop now?
No, I think this episode's all right.
Because the more this episode sucks... And the more longer it is, the more that you're going to get mad and you're going to have to edit all this crap.
See,
you're
going to
regret
you totally...
it. You're like, why did I let that madness go on so long? I have to talk about Optimus Prime?
No, it's, you know, every single episode we say this episode is horrible. And every single episode we're right. So, I mean, I think...
If you really want to hear him complain, Knox, you got to get him talking about anime. That's when he really starts whining.
Well, yeah, I'll be honest that I've seen one or two anime that was absolutely fantastic, but anything with people shooting power beams or yelling while their hair flares, their big blue hair flares, or anything like that. It's just
has to be blue hair.
Yeah, I mean all that stuff. I mean, there are really, really good anime, just like there's really good movies in any kind of genre. But just the majority of the stuff that I end up seeing is crap.
Yeah, same here. I mean, I'm sure there's good anime, but most of the crap I see, I don't understand.
Maybe you should try, putting on the English subtitles, Knox. I heard that helps a lot.
Yeah, it might help. I might have to do that with the Spanish channel as well. What the hell is that clown saying? I don't understand.
You don't need to do that with the Spanish channel. Yeah, you don't watch the Spanish channel for what they're saying. Come on.
Oh, hey.
Watch it for the hot chicks.
Yeah, watch it for the fat guy with the mustache. That's awesome. Love that guy. I am Spanish.
Oh, man.
Los dias de la, los torres aquí, yo soy Ponerse Verde.
That's exactly how it sounded.
You should be a Spanish voiceover.
Actually, I don't remember if I
Spanish
said it right.
Controllers.
I don't remember if I said it right, but I think that means the day of the rat is here and I'm turning green.
Well, that's very true, Jason.
It's the only Spanish phrase I know, and I don't even know if I say it right.
Well, you have the perfect voice. You should do Spanish commercials.
Why?
Out of all the crap we've been talking about, that's the only thing that you question? Jesus Christ. It took me 3 years to ask why.
Yeah. So, Matt.
The only thing that actually makes sense, you have the voice
Matt,
of
Matt, I'm gonna ask you right now. Save the show. Okay, something funny.
Gonna go ahead and go in the back.
You have a spot like that?
Say something funny, Matt.
Fried cancer.
What?
Fried cancer.
Oh, that's hilarious.
Man, you had your shot and you ruined it,
Thank
Matt.
Thank you.
The show is dead.
Thank you.
I can say something funny.
Thank you.
I gotta start reading spam messages. Let's see.
Thank you.
Your
the toaster's building its own.
Cabin. Dear homeowner, your credit Thank doesn't you. Matter to us. If you own Thank real you. Estate and want immediate cash to
Thank
spend
you.
Any way you like, or Thank simply wish to lower your
email.
Monthly
Thank
payments.
You. That was mean. You're not a nice person.
Who?
You.
Oh, here's an email I got. Oh wow, Viagra, Levitra, Viagra and Cialis. Cialis.
Oh wow.
Okay, you're getting cell phone emails, I'm getting Viagra emails. What the hell's going on here?
Yeah, it tells you what kind of sites you're going to.
Oh man.
A custom logo that expresses your company. What is this, tricky revolutionary war?
It's a revolutionary war that's kind of tricky.
How does that work? Does anyone actually open an email called Tricky Revolutionary War? It says Trading Alert, Equal Trading Incorporated, Don't Wait Now, Watch Out. How does this... I don't understand how people fall for any of this crap. It doesn't really make sense.
I never fall for any of it. I fall for it, but not because I get a lot of insane emails from fans, so I can never tell what's crazy fan mail or what's just stupid spam.
Dear Knox, I'm gonna cut you!
What?
Oh, I got another Viagra email. What the hell are they implying here?
I've been watching all your movies for a long time, and the only thing that I want to say to you is, I want to eat your heart!
Oh, God. God. I hear enough of that from my mom. She's lost her mind. She's been after my heart for years. Along with my ex-girlfriends. Ba-ba-bing.
Ba-doom.
I want your heart.
How about that, airline food, huh? I'm here all night.
Don't forget to tip the waiter, yeah.
Yeah. So, the Beatles, eh? Yep.
Aren't they, like, just about all dead.
They're dead. Ba-da-ba-ding. They're dead.
Isn't like two of them still alive, though?
We are happy to present you with 6 deals from our different brokers. Please remember that there is no commitment required on your part, and your credit is not an issue.
Okay, I got an email saying that I bought a Kids Bop CD. What the hell? Kids Bop 10. Is this fake? What the hell is going on?
That's probably what it is, too.
Boom, bop, ba doo da ba da boom.
Save the show, Matt.
When Hanson first came out, I thought the lead singer was a chick.
That's an old joke. Come on.
Yeah, but I'm telling the truth.
Everyone.
Hey, do your impersonation of me, Matt.
When I was a kid, I thought Michael Jackson was a chick.
I thought Cher was a man.
Odd. Yeah, Cher does.
Do your impersonation of me, Matt. Do your Knox impersonation, Matt.
I have a Knox impersonation?
No, just do one. Jason did it last week.
I just start talking and I'll do it.
Okay, hey, look, I'm Knox.
You guys just talk to one another and I'll randomly start acting like you.
Alright.
Okay, hey Jason.
Hey, what's up,
hey,
what's up?
Cell phone sandwiches.
Wow.
Birds on a hot tin fence.
Well, I just,
peanut butter and Snicker snacks.
Talking about Superman.
My phone's on fire.
Yeah, Superman.
My phone's on fire. My phone's on fire. My phone.
Okay, I don't.
It's on fire.
I don't just sit in the background and make random voices.
Yeah, well, you did about a fourth of this show.
I just sit in the background and yell stupid crap. I've never done that ever.
I think Knox needs to hit the rewind button on this episode. Then.
You know what? I think I'll do that.
You know what people can do? This is an interactive show. Here's what I want everyone to do. Everyone who's listening, I want you to go to imdb.com. I want you to search for Spatula Madness. And under where it says vote here, I want you to vote 10. Or 9.
Wait, are we
ten
telling the vote?
Now.
Or 8.
We're counting on you.
Well, because it has this weird, like, weighted vote system. So my ranking is 4.4, even though I have mostly good votes.
But you have the new Spatula Madness coming out soon.
I know, but I want the old one to have a better score.
Vote for Clay World off the table and Clay World series while you're at it.
Don't.
Even though I'm at a 9.9 already. Don't.
Don't bother with that. Don't waste your time.
Your dark overlord commands you.
Damn it! This is my show. This is my plane. Get off my plane.
It's a plane.
It's a bus.
Jason.
We're on the rock bus.
Rock and rock a locka, rock a locka, rock a locka, rock a locka, rock a
rock a locka, huh? What are you, Fuzzy Bear?
Robert.
What?
I want to start a pop band, kind of like Josie and the Pussycats. We'll all wear little cat ears.
Oh,
can I be
God
in it?
Yes, of course you're gonna be in it. Yeah, you're gonna wear some cat ears.
I am not getting in that band.
What instrument will I play?
Doesn't matter, as long as you put on some cat ears. You can play the tambourine for all I care.
Awesome. Can I play the pin?
As long as you put on the cat ears.
The
what about
cat
you, Matt?
Ears will...
I'll put on some cat ears.
I'll do lead vocals from the safety of behind a screen where no one can see me in the gay cat outfit.
I'm afraid that is the wrong answer, Matt. Come on, you'll play the brush.
The brush? How do you play a brush?
Yeah, you take a brush, you brush something, and then it makes a brushing sound.
Brush your headache away? Or heartache away, that's how it was.
Brush your heart. That could be our first single. Brush your heartache away.
I really hope that there's some guy with white hair sitting on an oak chair somewhere in West Virginia or something, listening to the show. And he has his hands folded out in front of him, and he's just thinking to himself, "This show concerns me." That's
this
what
is
I
gonna
hope
make it. This show, this episode right here, is gonna make it all the way to the president, and he's gonna be like,
"The nurses take him back to his padded room,
gentlemen. We've got to do something about those boys.
Yeah.
Something seriously wrong with America if that shit can go on. I want them killed. Assassinate
Bring it on.
Start with Steele. He'll be the toughest one.
Hey, what's that supposed to mean? I'm the one with the fan base. I got an army, damn it.
Knox looks a little scrawny.
I got an army of
kids
and Christians.
We love you, Knox. We protect you. Everyone pile on Knox.
Oh, God. I'm just...
Everyone pile on Knox. Come on.
Oh, I'm just taking it up the yin-yang today.
I'm protecting you, Knox. I'm protecting you with my body.
Bop, bop, with the beeper up there.
It's so great. Hot, I've got to take off my shirt.
Oh. Hold my teddy bear, Knox. I'll take a bullet for you.
You know what? At least I'll be alive, okay?
We love you!
Form a chain of love, Rat Knox.
The love chain! Love chain! It's so
we
sweet!
Love Knox!
Love you, Knox! You're my everything!
I can't make the right love chain! Their bows won't hurt us!
This isn't even a show anymore, this is just noise. Talking about freaking love chains at 11 o'clock at night.
Knox, before I die, kiss me.
Okay.
Right on the lips.
I'm your number one fan, Knox.
Come on, Knox, just a little bit of tongue.
God, you're both just making me cry.
Look, Knox,
I'm about ready to just walk over there and go to sleep.
I knitted this for you, Knox. I totally knitted it.
Oh, you're both gonna die.
I'm gonna get an email. I know it. I'm never watching your show again.
You have totally hit the bottom of the barrel.
We're gonna get tons of posts on the forum. People are gonna be like, this is the worst episode ever. I love the show, but this show sucks.
If I ever see you in real life, I swear to God, I'm gonna kick you in the crotch.
Every single episode.
They're like, I love this show, but this episode sucked.
Every episode. The show is great, really, but this one sucked. So is the last one. And all the ones that came previous.
It felt like I threw up in my own mouth several times.
Seriously, I'm your biggest fan, but I hate all of your work.
But you guys think it's bad listening to it. You should try being on it. Sheesh.
No, it's fun being on it. It's just probably not fun listening to it.
Yeah. Oh, no, it's totally different.
Oh, we are having so much fun right now, aren't we? Making fun of Knox.
I totally agree with all those posters. This.
They're right. I mean, it sucks.
This is bad.
Coughing brought to you by allergies. Allergies, the ultimate fun
destroyer.
Nice
way of saying this sucks. Maybe I should just stop talking.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's actually a couple of people who have posted saying that they listen to this while they go to sleep.
Yeah, that's true. I've read those. Randomly, wow. You should just insert loud, obnoxious noises.
Well, we have Knox.
Well,
or like
can't
car
use this
crashes.
One to go to sleep.
Just insert car crashes randomly over
nothing
top.
Nothing like
of this
listen
episode.
To me sing about.
Save the baby!
Wake up! Wake up! You have to kill the government. You must help.
You
must help with the uprising.
I can't do it.
You must help, Communist China.
No.
Overthrow capitalism.
Overthrow
government.
Well, we've been going for an hour or so.
Uh-oh.
It's been an hour?
Yeah, it's been an hour.
An hour of fun? Actually, Tom told me that my webmaster told me that our shorter shows actually do better. So yeah, this show is probably not going to do better. I guess. Oh, God. You know,
It's been fun. It's been real.
40 years
from
now, you and me
fun.
Are going to look back and listen to this crap.
No, I'm never going to listen to this again.
Yeah,
no. I probably will.
I basically
when I'm
get
old.
Like one listen per show.
Like, oh, I remember when I used to do a radio show. I wonder what that was like. And then I'd remember and I'd cry.
Then you'll watch into it and you'll be like, oh, God, I did a radio show.
I'd hang myself while shooting myself in the face on live camera.
Yes.
Like, here I go.
You'd be like, in case anyone remembers me.
They told me I was going to be famous. My nose is really runny.
Yeah, allergies are bad.
I'm from Texas, yeah. I'm from Texas,
I'm hard. I don't have allergies.
I'm from Texas, yeah. I like...
So Matt, yeah? what would you rank this episode?
A negative 12.
Negative 12?
Even though I'm on it, a negative 12.
It's our best one yet.
Do you really think this is our best one, or are you just joking?
Yeah, I'm not being
like serious. When it's done recording, are you just gonna get out of the Jason character and just go, yeah, that sucked?
No, I gotta stop this because we do this every episode. Every single episode, we say, man, this episode's horrible. It's like half the show, half of every single show we record is us talking about how bad it is.
You didn't in the Atomic Devastation one.
Oh yeah, that's true. Well, that episode was actually, I think that was probably the only good episode we did.
We were in character through like the whole episode. It wasn't even like us. It was just us. And
I guess we did it pretty good because we got emails asking if it was real.
People actually thought it was real. Some people were really offended for some reason.
I thought you were actually eating a cat, so I ate a cat.
No, I almost believed I was there too.
It's not as good as you made it out to be, to be honest.
I wasn't in Canada and Jason wasn't in my lap.
It's really kind of stringy. Tough.
Sammy is still alive. So.
Not very tasty. Maybe if I fry it, maybe it wouldn't be so bad.
You gotta fry cat.
Oh, that's the. I don't know. Is this a good show, Jason? Is it worth doing every week?
You know what? I'm gonna say yes, even though I think no.
Next episode, save KnoxKast Marathon. Call 1-555-666-4321 if you want to save the show. Call 1-555-234 if you don't want to save the show.
We should find someone who works like for the post office or something and interview them.
Yeah, we should really do that.
That would be awesome.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
Super awesome.
Yeah, well, we're gonna stop the show now. I think it's gone on for long enough.
Yeah.
Awesome.
So any last words, Matt, before we fade off into that cold night?
As you drift off to sleep tonight, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like you to think about me, because I can't sleep. I'll probably be up till 6:30, 7 in the morning.
Playing World of Warcraft.
No, I will not be playing World of Warcraft. Hate you. Hate you.
Are you playing World of Warcraft right now?
Do you want an honest answer?
And with that, we're gonna end. So,
yeah.
Good night, everyone.
Good night, everybody, and
or good morning if you're.
Good night. Good morning.
Good afternoon.
You know why are you even listening to this? You know the TV's probably a few feet away. You just plug it on.
Maybe they're like on the bus television to school or something, or you can take a taxi to work. You know.
You can turn on the radio and listen to people who actually know what the hell they're talking about.
No,
if you listen to some music,
like conglomerate radio stations playing.
Maybe
the same
read a
songs
book.
Isn't that sad though?
What?
That this is actually better than some mainstream stuff.
That is actually pretty.
Because
sad.
Because the show is pretty. No, I think the only reason people listen is because it's better than certain things in comparison.
Normally, I don't listen to the radio at all when I'm in my car. I just listen to my iPod, but it's recently broke. So I found myself having to resort back to the radio again. Mm-hmm. And I literally want to, like, rip my ears out. Because it's like, they're still playing, like, songs from, like, 5-10 years ago. And they're like, coming up next, it's this band. And, oh my god, are they awesome. I know you guys have been waiting for it all day. I'm like, are you kidding me?
I've been sitting by my radio waiting to hear the Macarena.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank God they don't play that anymore.
Oh, God.
God, I was Black Sabbath. Put your hands together for Ozzy and the band. Yeah.
Hey, yeah. Okay, we better go.
Yeah. I'll see y'all later.
Yeah.
Hasta la bye-bye.
Yeah, and remember,
keep playing that pen, kids.
Okay. Yeah.
One day it's not going to make you any money.
Keep practicing.
Everyone will hate you.
Stay in school. Don't do drugs.
Don't
kill
do
anybody.
Pen either, because it'll get you beat up.
Don't kill anybody. I'll kick your ass.
Yeah. See y'all later.
Goodbye.